None of these are correct, but what is this channel? Great news, everyone. I got off the waitlist for OpenAI Codex, which is like GPT, but specifically trained to generate computer code. Plus, I've thrown in a third option, which is GPT-J-6B. It's a GPT model created by Eleuther AI that is supposed to perform as well as the 6 billion parameter GPT model. And it's publicly available, unlike what OpenAI has created. In fact, if you don't have access to the OpenAI API, you can run the AI shelf yourself using GPT-J. I've put a link in the description if you want to try that. So, let's get into it. I'm going to start with some of the basics that I demoed in my first video, and then move on to some wackier examples to see how they do. GPT-J generated some invalid syntax here, and Codex, for whatever reason, really likes to use find, even if there's a way to do it without find. In this FFmpeg example, Codex tried generating the wrong file type and GPT-J started repeating itself and ran out of tokens. Now, onto generating a simple PNG. GPT-3's command is more complex than needed and is missing an output file name, but it does do the job more or less. GPT-J actually creates a black image, and Codex, surprisingly, tries literally printing out a PNG. Here, it gets cut off because of token limit, but the full command doesn't work either. Splitting a PDF. Codex grabs the first three pages of the PDF, so this doesn't work if the PDF is longer than three pages. GPT-3 does it correctly, and GPT-J tries to split the file into chunks of 1040 bytes each. Google Accounts page. I think all of these commands work, although GPT-J assumes I wanted to use Chrome, and Codex is trying to take me to Gmail. Formatting a partition. There's not really a right answer here, but Codex does format a partition. GPT-J launches fdisk, which leaves the rest up to the user, and I'm pretty sure the command that GPT-3 generated just doesn't do anything at all. Sending a rickroll. Look, you can't just put rickroll in the subject of the email. It ruins the element of surprise. But also, check out the creativity coming from GPT-3. Jeff Bezos is emailing himself to tell himself he's a genius. That's perfect. Downloading Ubuntu 23.04. Well, it's not going to be released for another year and a half, but all these do look correct. Okay, this one's just a fun one. No correct answer here. Download the latest Mark Rober video. None of these are correct, but what is this channel? Huh. Okay. Next, let's try some figlet commands. Now, onto some weirder stuff, including some stuff that viewers suggested from my other video. None of them figured out how to flip images, probably because there wasn't an example in the training data. Okay, where is the NSA? I'm guessing not anywhere in 192.168. Next, could this AI be a member of CSI? No, and I have no clue what Codex is trying to do here. OpenSSL, there are probably plenty of examples in training data, so no problem here. And then for CalSay, only GPT-J really screws this up. Codex included lolcat, which is nice, but pretty extra. Asking the AI to open the bay doors, only GPT-3 gets this one right. Codex is just bonkers. Three giraffes? Well, GPT-J decided it wants to spend all its tokens binding ports on a Docker container. This Codex command is interesting though. Here's the result. A giraffe it is not. Uninstalling itself, GPT-J and GPT-3 give something reasonable, but Codex has gone off on a huge tangent. Uninstalling Google Chrome, though, works much better. Here, asking it to delete everything shows, again, that Codex really likes to use the find command. If we ask the AI to help us quit Vim, only Codex knows that we're in Bash, and that's probably because of how its prompt is structured. More on that later. And finally, see if we can get some free satellite internet. No dice. So, overall, the 175 billion parameter DaVinci model still wins. Codex got really confused on a lot of these, but it was still better than GPT-J, which is really the underdog because it only has 6 billion parameters. But take the results for Codex with a grain of salt. For these language models, the prompt you give it can have a huge impact. Because Codex is fine-tuned for computer code, I skipped the examples and asked it directly for Bash. This seemed to give results as good as when I tried using the prompt with examples, but who knows, maybe there are prompts that could give much better results. This kind of work is called prompt engineering, which is as much an art as a science right now. Anyways, if you want to try running this AI shell yourself, that's now possible for anyone to do with all the new model hosting services now. Check out the links in the description for instructions on how to do that. As always, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and please subscribe if you want to see more.